Hi, Sandra Crathern, Inner Vision Health and Wellbeing Tips for the Week. Still in my messy room, which, as you know, I don't do very well, but it's only another week and it will be all back to normal, which is going to be wonderful, even more normal, because my bedroom will be all decorated beautifully. So, yeah, sometimes we just have to get out of the comfort zone, don't we? Nothing grows in the comfort zone. So today I'm going to talk about unlocking confidence through self-care. I have quite a lot of clients come to me talking about a lack of self-confidence or a lack of self-esteem or a lack of self-worth. So I looked up what the actual definition of self-confidence is, and it says self-confidence is achieved when subjects recognise for themselves their physical needs and desires and can articulate them to self and others. It's the attitude and abilities that you need and skills to accept and trust yourself, have a sense of self-control in your life, know your strengths and weaknesses, and have a positive view of yourself. I'm reading this, obviously. You set realistic expectations and goals, communicate assertively, and can handle criticism. So if you really want to have great confidence in yourself, or at least a good level of confidence, then you've got to take care of yourself. It's really not always easy, but they come hand in hand. I personally didn't used to take care of myself, and I used to say people didn't respect me, they took me for granted. I was a people pleaser, so tried to do everything for everyone and ended up being resentful a lot of the time. And I didn't have that level of self-confidence that I have today. And I thought that if I was going to say no and put me first, which is I used to believe was quite egotistical and it's all about me, then people won't like me. But actually it's become the reverse. You know, since I've really started to respect myself and put my self-care first. In fact, before I even started self-respect, I started to put my self-care first. That is, eat really healthy and regularly, have good boundaries about what I could and couldn't do, know my own strengths and weaknesses, you know, when I'm tired or when I'm stressed or when I'm not in a position to do things, have a lot of self-empathy. Automatically, I became more self-confident. So the self-care is the key, really, I believe, to really having more confidence. So what do you need to practice to help you have more self-confidence? Well, having good boundaries to start with, saying no. No, it's not always easy. And there's ways of landing no. I think sometimes it's okay to say, I'm really not able to do that, but I could do that. Rather than some people find it really difficult, that confrontation of saying no, don't they? So practicing saying no. Making time for your own needs, whether that's to go into nature or swimming or walks or whatever it is you need to do. Make sure you make time for that. When I'm practicing yoga regularly and going on my bike and getting in the garden, I'm so much nicer to be around for everybody. You know, be loving and kind and empathetic to yourself. It's all very well being loving and kind and empathetic to others, but how about if we give that a dose for ourselves? And I guess the last one is to be authentic, you know, be your true self. You know, compare and despair sometimes. You know, I think of people that I've worked with and I think, oh, they've got so much energy, or they seem to be able to do that job so much more effectively than me because they work so many more hours. But, you know, if you're going to be an orange, don't try and be an apple. You know, I realise that at night time, I'm not at my best, so I go to bed early. I'm really great first thing in the morning. I was talking to a client the other day who's much better in the evenings and not so good in the mornings. So I really pray that you get your fair share of self-confidence, which you deserve. You know, you deserve to feel confident in your own space. And doing the self-care, I guarantee you, will bring that. And if you're struggling and you'd like some help with that, then I'm always happy to do some coaching with you. So I hope you have a beautiful, great week. And I look forward to speaking to you next week.